I close my eyes, only for a moment, then the moment's gone, and all my dreams pass before my eyes, curiosity dust in the wind, all they are is dust in the wind. Same old song, just a drop of water in the endless sea, and all we do crumbles to the ground, though we refuse to see. Dust in the wind, all we are is dust in the wind.
So in the early 1960s, I was drowned by my master's mother in a bathtub. It was a failed attempt. Master survived.
Obviously you survived too.
No. Sadly, I didn't survive. Not really. I never came out of the tub. I remained under the water, hidden. No one knew. You see, I was a part of my master's inner self. I died that day and was mummified. My master couldn't bear for me to suffer. He knows how sensitive I am. I don't pretend to understand the mystical. I was part of my master, and after the betrayal, I wasn't.
How ironic. His mother's mercy killing was the very thing he did to you. That's extraordinary hypocrisy. So there was this traumatic act of domestic violence long ago, and you fell out of your master's mind.
Fell? Not exactly. But that's close. He separated from me to protect me. He left me there, preserved for the day when it would be safe for me to come out again. I'm on a journey now to find him so we can be reunited.
But you are young. He must be an old man now.
He is old. His body is ravaged. But he's been waiting for this day.
So what will this reunion be like?
He doesn't realize. It probably means everything to him. We are aligned and at ease with each other. He's been empty for a long time. In every young woman, he searches deep to see if I am there inside. He sometimes glimpsed me in others. It was like he forgot who I was or where I was, even though he always continued searching for me. A yearning, really. I was his invisible companion. I was his tenderness. The soft part he had to discard to survive emotionally. He felt he had to protect me. He thought it an act of kindness.
It was an act of kindness?
It was hell. I've missed him so. All alone in the darkness for decades, wondering what happened to him, never realizing what had gone wrong.
What happened to him?
After our separation, without me, he became hardened and brittle, afraid. He sensed danger in everything, paranoia. He never could sleep well after the drowning attempt. He wasn't safe sleeping, because he never was before. He couldn't see the beauty of life and living. The pain scarred him. The betrayal was deep. It's a miracle he survived. He lost his sanity at different times. He couldn't remember the trauma. He was fighting invisible monsters.
Are you his inner child?
Perhaps. But I am female. He was a boy then. Now he is a man. I don't know how, after such a long separation, we will be unified again. He lived. I have not. He nears the end of his life. What benefit can come from our late union?
Maybe you'll both heal from what happened in the past.
My master thinks he can't be healed in this life. He's given up searching. His body lost its strength. He supposes it's a waiting game, and death will finally release him.
Is he wrong?
No. He's not wrong. Death is a merciful release. But I'm not ready to die again. I've just come back. We're so close to unification. He can't give up yet.
What do you think will happen? Will he be restored?
restored? Not physically, but he'll find peace knowing I'm back. Then he can feel safe again, trust again.
You mean he will trust you, and that fixes things inside of him?
In a matter of speaking, yes. He will trust his soul again, especially his spirit. I am his inspiration. His power of being strange will feel acceptable and normal instead of damaged. You know, a portion of him was missing for decades. That missing fragment is me, his internal spirit guide. He couldn't trust his perceptions. He had no confidence in his feelings.
That's a wild story. Haven't you seen him yet?
Well, it's not easy. Not only were we separated for years, but we've been almost 2,000 miles apart, a long distance traveling on foot. Also, it was key he remember I was missing. I couldn't even begin to come out of that tub until then. That didn't happen until after the death of his mother some years ago. He didn't remember me all at once. It took time. He had a sort of amnesia.
When you're together again, what do you think it'll be like for you and your master?
I don't know exactly, but I imagine it will be liberating. Sad in some ways because of the time we spent apart. A loss to grieve. But there will be something wonderful in seeing the world differently. The old pain may leave, who knows?
You think your master will want to experience what the two of you felt before?
We don't even remember what that felt like. We only know that we both yearn to fill an emptiness. I don't think it's shouting, but more of silence. A realization the pain is gone. The absence of something we recognize first. A quiet inside. And then perhaps a potential reconstruction.
What's in the way?
His body is damaged. It's in the way now.
His body?
He can't run and jump or dance. You know that. I'm 140 years old inside.
Right, I forgot. Will he sleep peacefully?
I hope so. We'll find out. I am his strangeness. When I embrace him again, it will change things for him. Self-acceptance is important for peace. He will feel my love for him again. We'll have the internal conversation of creative imagination again. Dreams, ideas. He can say what he feels to me and know he is accepted and loved. Always. I don't care what others think of Master. This is who he is. And I refuse to be disapproving. We have the opportunity to rebuild ourselves.
Don't hang on. Nothing lasts forever but the earth and sky. It slips away. And all your dust in the wind, all we are is dust in the wind, yeah. Dust in the wind.